Good morning, my crafty friends. Today's video is a little bit different. It's not a journal share. I thought I tried to craft and turn the camera on. I don't make a lot tutorials or craft with me. Not that I don't like it or I wish I could do it, but because I have difficulties to craft, to think, and to speak in a foreign language. That's the reason. But I thought today, I tried it yesterday, but I was so confused about the news on TV. I had deleted 3 videos because I was not in my best mood. What I try to plan is today to make more of mixed media tags. Here you can see I've already started some. They are collaged, gessoed, stenciled, stamped, and inked. I made this yesterday. I made yesterday others. Sorry, it's a little bit difficult to find a start. I want to do something similar because I have planned to use some images from Mrs. Cox as a focal point, and I want more mixed media background text. So it is a good method. We all, even if we have no toilet paper or not enough, we have this, tons of scraps. So last year I had my scraps organized in plastic bags, but plastic. I tried to change everything to avoid plastic, and it was a mess. It was not organized in plastic bags. It was our stuff, everything in plastic bags. So I ended up with 8 bags. And I thought that I need another solution. So I came up with the idea. Don't know if it works for you. I have this box and it's full of scraps. And my goal, and I think it's a good idea, if this is full, this one box, not the second box, this one box, if it's full, I need to use up as much as I can, and I do this at the moment. We should spend all our, let me sit down. So everyone should stay at home, so we have lots of time. Good way to use up as much scraps as we can. So like I said, it's a little bit difficult to find a start. So this here, it's a register. It's a light cardstock, maybe, I would say. And I want to cover this here up. And then later I want to cut tags out of that. And I want to use up my scraps. So I pull here out whatever I have on top. At this stage, it doesn't matter what scraps it is. This here is a boo-boo that I made recently. I tried to spray a paper sack. It was an ugly thing. It turned out really ugly. So I have music. I have here a jelly print. There's a printable. These are leftovers from previous projects. I have also some mop-up pages, for example here, this was also left over. So I use whatever I have here, and it doesn't matter at this point if it matches from the color together, if it doesn't matter if it's large or little pieces, because it will be just be a background. So I tear them into pieces. Doesn't matter if they have here a white border. It's just the background, and I want to cover this register up. Later on, I will use gesso and stamps and maybe stenciling and colors, but you will see it when I'm doing this. I try to talk a little bit with you. That's the most difficult part for me. Not to talk with you, but to find the words while I'm crafting. Maybe I'm not multitasking, I don't know. So, it's easy said to not to overthink it, but I know it myself. At one point I think, oh, maybe here or there, and try not to think too much. That's what I would say. I have glue sticks. This is just the cheapest brand here in Germany, and I'm the lucky winner because it's also the best glue. I will need later an ink pad that is that stays on, so it's not removable with water. Stays on as a permanent ink. This and my gesso. This is also a German brand. You don't have to use gesso. You can use gesso. You can use any gesso you want. You can use your homemade gesso if you wanted to. I have here a cleaner for my stamp, and I use matte gel medium. You can use Mod Podge because we need a sealer for the paper later. But first, let me start with just gluing pieces onto. Oh, I have here this from the book left, and I glue here on top. So let's just start randomly putting the pieces of scraps here on this register. Doesn't matter which direction. All I do is I let them always a little bit overlapping. That's what I do. So, and if you hear me a little bit sniffing, it's an allergy. The pollen are starting to fly around, so that's why I'm sniffing a bit. I try to go with an allergy into a supermarket and buy something. The people are immediately in panic. I can understand this is really a serious thing, but it's not so nice if you have an allergy and you need to do your grocery shopping. It's difficult. So, I hope everybody's doing well crafting at home. So, to get over this crisis, I think I want something. Something. I have this. There you go. No. Ah, yeah. I just tear this white border off. I don't know why I'm doing this. Because it doesn't matter, because we will put all the other stuff on top. Don't know why I'm doing this. So, yesterday our counselor Mrs. Merkel held a press conference. Well, it was more than time. We are now no longer to spend time in public. So that means no, our schools are closed. All bars, discotheques, museums, theaters, All that is closed now. All sports, excuse me, all sports things are cancelled and closed, and we are yet not on lockdown, complete on lockdown, but excuse me. No, guys, that's not something that is every year that I'm coughing and sneezing in spring. So no things to spend leisure time outside or inside. There are no activities, no social life outside the house. That's what she said. So nothing in public. We are allowed to go to the post office if we need to. Gas station and supermarkets to get groceries, if you can get groceries. And to work. So the work companies, offices haven't yet closed, but I'm sure this will come. This needs to. But no social life outside the house anymore. I can live with that. I don't spend a whole year a lot in the public, so I'm fine with that. Oh, and no traveling inside or outside Germany. So not just make holidays in Spain. That was my plan for May, for the next at least, and I'm pretty sure that's not all the, at least for 30 days, we are not allowed to travel across the borders and not in our own country. So if I would want to spend my vacation in south of Germany, it's not allowed, no traveling. I wanted to spend my vacation in Spain in May, yet they say 30 days, but I'm pretty sure they will change it to whatever days. And it's okay, it's for healthcare, I'm okay with that. It's sad, but I'm okay, I stay at home. I can spend my vacation and visit my friends there later. That's okay for me. Not a problem. But what really is scaring me is the craziness of the people in the supermarket. They buy really everything. Hardly beverage. Hardly fresh vegetables. Frozen vegetables sold out. And I don't talk now about this craziness with the toilet paper. No tin cans, no noodles, no rice, no flour, no... What really makes me a little bit angry is that also restaurants have purchased the flour from the supermarket so that we cannot get flour. It's all sold out. I think it's time that the supermarkets put a limit on this, but who knows if and when this happens. The supermarkets, they really work hard to try to get more groceries for us because of the craziness of some. I'm confused about all this. No soap, no shower gel. It's all sold out. And here where I live more in the countryside. I'm the lucky winner. I'm not living in a big town. that's maybe something good. It will not save me, but maybe I have luck. What I want to say. So we have not here in the countryside, we have not so many stores, and I see right now I have here something. Oh, sorry, the camera. So I'm sorry, I had to remove here something from the camera. So we have not so many stores here. Here where I live, we have one supermarket. The next is kilometers away, and I have no car. I can use the car from the neighbor once a week to get my groceries, but then I need to, at this one day, I need to drive wherever I can find something, and that's really scaring me. So it's not just that tons of toilet papers are sold out. Everything is now sold out. And if it's super difficult, because if you have not so much money, you cannot hoard the groceries. And you cannot get, at this stage, you cannot get enough. And that's really what scares me. So, some people here said, oh, you are late. You are great, thank you. So, this is so egoism from some people. And also the people with less income, or with almost no income. We have here an organization, it's called The Table, and they get donations from the supermarket, and they give it to the poor and people with less income, to people who cannot buy enough or no groceries. So it's an organization, I don't know if that's called correctly, they feed the poor, and they have closed, not just because of this virus, but they have no donation. No supermarket can donate food to this organization because every single piece is sold out. So that means, and it makes me really sad, the people in need or with less, they get nothing at the moment. Excuse me. Because people are egoism and buy everything, even if they don't need it. Excuse me. Usually I would have here stop, because I don't like to cry on camera, but yesterday at Linda Israel's live, a colleague and a friend told me sometimes it's necessary to speak out my mind. Excuse me. So that's the situation. Not just that we are not allowed to travel, I don't care. But it's difficult to see this. So it's difficult for me to see this madness. And I try to drive to the supermarket in at different days, in different times, no, nothing. And this, I mean, I can talk. This really hurts me to see that there people in panic. I can understand the panic, of course, but that they are so egoism and don't think about other people or the people in need. So I think I should stop talking about this, otherwise I cry more. Let me take a little bit of coffee. Zip or two. Okay, thank you for giving me your ears. And I think I need to take all this with a little bit of humor. Otherwise, I freak out and I don't want this panic. I'm already in fear, but I try not that the panic catches me. So I stay at home most of the time of my life, that's fine, so nothing changes for me. I just go to the grocery, usually to the office, post office, groceries, supplies for my bunnies, to the doctor. So this is still allowed, so nothing for me changes. But when then I see that schools are closed, all leisure time activities are prohibited, the kids, they should stay at home and they gather with friends in the park. I find no words for such stupidness. So here I think are the parents who needs to talk to their kids. No, it's not easy if they're a teenager and such, but it is so important now that also kids and teenagers stay at home. So that's what I wanted to say. Maybe I should stop really. Oh, I like this. Maybe I should really stop talking about this. So I stay at home. I'm fine with that. Sad and hard to get my supplies. Shampoo sold out. I have a little bit at home, so for the next days or for a week I'm fine. But I'm really in need to think about next week. This is so crazy. But we can craft every time now. And I will. That's what I'm doing here. All the days that I spend at home. At least this is fine. Oh, maybe to change the topic, maybe you allow me to make a little bit of advertising, because look what I made. You cannot see it. So I have this big basket full of supplies and stuff like that, and it's all added to my shop. Yes, I thought I have so many fussy cut elements, so many ruffles from sari ribbon, that I want to upload this to my shop, to share some of my stuff. I made so many cluster in December, and want it this way. So many cluster tags. I have uploaded some mixed media tags. Now I have, I glue it here down. Mixed media tags, cluster mixed media tags with and without focal point. I have a whole set of ready-made embellishments and supplies for a botanical journal, sari ribbon ruffles, and much, much more. So not just journals in my shop for the future, also something from the other projects that I'm doing here all the time. And if you want to check them out, thank you so much. There are lots of items now listed, so maybe you like to check them out. So I have, it's not enough advertising now for me. So I close this glue stick. It's now covered. I will now cut the excess off. And then I will use some gesso, white gesso. I'll tell you the reason in a bit. So that's then the back side, and it's great to journal, no? So I have now this here, and because I want to use later color and I want that the colors pop up out more, I need to turn this a little bit into the background. You don't have to do this if you like this, perfect. I'm using now a little bit, if I open the bottle, a little bit of white gesso. If it's not, I think the hole is I need a needle. Okay, so now, so I have the gesso now on my book page, not directly here on this page, using it, but just a little amount here on my book page. And all I do is just randomly put the gesso on top. That's how I do it. I'm pretty sure that is not professional mixed media style. This is mumbo jumbo funny style. So it looks now, it's very thick in once, in a few, hello, talking, thinking and crafting, right. It looks a little bit thick in one, in some spaces, but when it's dry, it will, it will change. Cannot explain it. So I'm using a dry brush. And when you use gesso, it brings all the different pieces a little bit more together. So here it looks now a little bit thick, this gesso, but when it's dry, it will the pattern underneath will show through, because gesso is I don't know the English word. It's not transparent because it's white, but I don't know the word, translucent. Is this translucent? I don't, but you get the idea what I want to say. So I am now fine with that. It's gonna exactly the amount that I want, and you see already it brought the different scraps more together. I hope that makes sense. So gesso dries very quickly, so I can almost immediately move on with, what do we want? Stamping. We want stamping. Or to reseal it. I'm confused. No, we seal it first. That was, yes, that's what I always did. I seal it with a layer of matte gel medium. You can use Mod Podge or any other medium that is a sealer. Excuse me, but I had this here left. So I seal it now because later on, excuse me, later on I want to use water here on top and inks. And if I would now use water here, all the scraps will come off again. That's not what we want. So I seal it. I have this matte gel medium. Don't know if it's the best. It's what I could afford. Cannot afford all crazy expensive stuff. And I had a coupon from Amazon, so I bought this on Amazon. I have heard it's a good thing, so I tried it, and it's really a good sealer, and you can also glue with it. That's what I did not knew before. So if now a piece here comes off, I just would go under it and glue it back to the page. And I'm okay with brush strokes. If you don't like brush strokes, this works especially with Mod Podge. You can use here such a tool, any spongy thingy, and then you dab this on top, the Mod Podge or the gel medium maybe, you dab this on top, so this avoids brush strokes. I like brush strokes because it's a mixed media background. I'm fine with that. And I don't want to be a perfectionist. Not in making mixed media art journals, junk journals, things. It's not necessary. I think if you want to make it perfect, do so. That's fine. So, to this corner here, and then I think then it needs to dry. So I have now everything covered. A little bit left here on my so. One thing I recommend, and I don't recommend a lot, is clean your brush. You destroy your brushes if you don't clean them as soon as you have something finished like that. This needs now to dry. I will dry it off camera because my heating tool is so loud and I'm not the technical crazy people to know how to edit my video with the volume down. So I will dry this off camera, then I will be back, and in between I clean my brush. Very important. So hold on. I am back. So this is now completely dry, and you can see the gesso is a little bit transparent. So all these layers will show through, but we are not finished yet. It's sealed so that when I play later with the water, it doesn't go on the paper. So the paper stays now, it's sealed, it's fine. Now stamping. You can use anything you want. Any stamp works. I have chosen to go with this one. This is from Beeline Designs. I purchased it from Linda Israel's shop. Link in the description box. It's not mounted, but it works like the Tim Holtz Stamps Anonymous Stamps, because they have here this, I don't know, this rubber thing, little bit, it sticks to your acrylic block. Yeah, it sticks there. I have chosen to go with stays on because it stays on. So it doesn't matter if I play later when it's dry. It doesn't smear when I use water. Using Timber Brown because it's a background. I have also a black, but I don't know if that is too much for my taste, so I use Timber Brown. And later I have this stays on cleaner. I think it's worth because I want to clean my stamps after I've used them with stays on, and I just clean them with this cleaner after I've used stays on. So with distress inks or oxides, you can just use water and clean them. But usually when you use stays on, the rest of the ink is here on this I'll show you an example. I have more stamps, trust me. So I have here this little flower thingies, and here you can see it's a dirty one. It's now okay. It was just happened once for me. I have forgotten to clean it with the, and after I've used stays on, and these were this year's cleaned later. So I like to clean my stamps when I used stays on. So, but you see it in a second. All I'm doing is randomly. I go also off the edges, so randomly on this page, and you can see when I go on the pad, oopsie, and I go on the pad, here's now a lot of stays on ink, here not. It's okay. It's background. So here now, here's more ink and here's less ink. It's fine. It's all fine. Oops. And because I cut them later into sizes, it looks maybe now like a totally mess, and it will later on looks more than a totally mess, but trust me, if as soon as you cut it into size, it looks great. That's my experience that I have discovered. If I don't worry now too much and later it really looks great. Here now you can see it's a little bit much stamping, but we also put a focal point on top. It's okay. It's fine. So I think that's fine now. Now you can close the ink pad. Now here this stays on cleaner. I don't squish it now, just here you can see there's a little felt thingy on top. All I'm doing is this. That's already enough. You can see it all already removes the stays on, and I'm using a paper towel because I have no toilet paper. No, I have toilet paper, but like I said, I need to take this all with humor. And you can see this stays on is already off the stamp. can also clean your acrylic block. And while I'm cleaning my stamps, I spent money on them and I want that they last a long time. I don't want to purchase so often new stamps. Great, great. So that was an investigation that was good. Okay, we have stamped. Now, let's think. I think I want to use brush or colors, and I need something. Wait, hold on. And my little water spray bottle. So I have here a little set of brush or colors. This is a pack of 8 colors. There are larger assortments out there, but they are not cheap. To try it out, I have decided to go with just 8 colors. These are yellow ochre, rose red, lime green, olive green, moss green, burnt sienna, sandstone, and terracotta. And so it's more in the direction of nature. Brushes is powder pigment, and it's they are mixed with different pigments and they react with water, and then they don't react like an ink spray where you have always the same color, so it's always a little bit a surprise. You should see it in a second. I move that box a little bit out of the way. Let me show you. So they come here in this little thingies, in these little containers, and I've poked here with an awl and a hole in this lid. I haven't made it too large because I don't want too large powder out of. Sorry, it was the chair. Now it's a little bit difficult to explain. I just want to put a little amount of this powder because you don't need really much. They react with water and they spread out. We have terracotta, yellow ochre, moss green maybe, rose red, yes. Olive green is difficult because it's very dark. Burnt sienna, I like burnt sienna. Sandstone and lime green, so the greens are in the bag. This will now become completely wet and a totally mess, but when it's dry, then it looks very different. So, I go with yellow ochre. I'm pretty sure you cannot see the less amount of this powder, or at all the powder. But so in the beginning, I'm a little bit careful with using much water, because you have no control over the colors. I like this a lot, but that's what you maybe should know. No control. You can place them here and there in the places you want, but as soon as you get water on it, spread out, so you can see it already. So I need a little bit more of this. Looks like a mess, and it will be much more mess, trust me. This was terracotta, yellow ochre, sandstone. I want a little bit more red. So slowly I have to be careful that it's not completely red, or you get the idea. So I don't know what how it will turn out. I think it will be pretty, but at the moment it's just wet and whooshy. I want a little bit of green in between. And I love this lime green. I love all the colors. And it looks now very bright. I know, but when it's dry, it's not that bright again. So you see the wishy. I like that. Olive green is a very dark thing. You have to be a little bit careful. As you can see here already. But I like it. I like it. So if you think here and there it's too much, you can just easily go here and remove a little bit of the water. And this is now the moment where if you don't seal it, all your pieces, all your scraps will come off. Right? Because usually we don't, and not with Mod Podge maybe, but with a glue stick. And I don't throw this away because when it's dry I can use it. And I want, where is it? Burnt sienna. I love this color. And I could move it around. Maybe I will do this. We never know when we change our mind. What if? I'm pretty sure I'm talking nonsense at the moment. So I think, let me see it through the camera. Oh, that looks like a mess. It is a mess, but it just looks wet, so messy. When it's dry, it's really lovely. So let me move it a little bit. Don't want to move it too much. So, but you can see all the layering and then they still show through. Here's something that I... And here, not sure yet. I think I go with burnt sienna. I like it. So I think it looks on camera not totally crazy and messy. It will. I show you this when it's dry. It will now take a longer time to dry it because it's really red. Yes. So I turn off the camera and let it dry, or I dry it, and then I will be back. Doo-doo, I'm back. So this piece looks now much better than before. So it's dried now. You still think it's a mess. It is maybe, but trust me, when we cut it into size, it will look much better. But we are not finished yet. I want more. So I go with a stencil on top. I don't know if it's called boxed flowers or such. It's a stencil from Linda Israel. And I want to stencil a little bit here on top. I have to. So I'm using this. Makeup brush thingy that I have received from my dear friend Carolina. and I will stencil here on top, but not the complete piece, just here and there. I'm using walnut stain. I have repurposed vintage photo ink pad and used a re-inker with walnut stain after the vintage photo was empty. So I place it here and I just go here in parts over this piece. And I do it in the lighter areas here, then you can see the pattern better. You don't have to stencil this. I like it. And it looks really great. And I finished it. I can move the stencil because when we cut it into size, it doesn't matter if there's an overlapping or not from this pattern. It's just to give it more texture. So, meanwhile, also a thing that has changed now since yesterday. Meanwhile, my mailman came and he brought me my trusty glue. This is a giant bottle. It's from Germany. It's a wooden glue from the hardware store. And it's really inexpensive. This giant bottle costs me now with shipping about $13, $12 or $13, and it lasts a long time, and I think it glues almost everything. It doesn't glue plastic, but if I want to glue paper to paper, it's very thick, so my paper doesn't have too many air bubbles. It dries in a good time. It glues fabric, so all that what I need here for the crafting except plastic. So where's my trusty glue? I once I have purchased this art glitter glue. This is a little bottle. It's a great glue, but it's so expensive. This little bottle costs me $21. Ridiculous price. Not 21 or 24. No matter, over $20, this little. I had a coupon code from Amazon, so I thought, let's try. We'll never purchase it again, not for the price. But I used this as a refiller. So I fill my trusty glue into this bottle, add a little bit water. That's also something that I can do with this glue from the wood glue from the hardware store. I can water it down to Mod Podge with a Mod Podge to decoupage with it, and that works. This glue works from the with the wood glue from the hardware store. It's water-based, I cannot use it as a sealer because it's not waterproof. There are others also from this company, and also wood glues in the hardware stores that are waterproof, but I don't need it, not really. So that was the glue. The mailman, that was weird. He brought this, but he's no longer allowed to hand it over to me in personal. So, no mail. They put it in front of our door. Then they ring the doorbell, and then in this next second, he's already gone. Oh, that was really weird. This is changed overnight now. They are no longer allowed to hand packages over in person. Okay. Let's continue with this project here. So now you can see this great stenciling here. And let me change something. Hold on, guys. So maybe we have now better light. Yeah, now it's better. So now you can see all this stenciling. Here's the stamping still visible, the all the colors, the stenciling. And now I will cut little tags out of the. I need to do it off here on the side, because my paper cutter is too large. Hold on, hold on, hold on. Don't run away. So I cut a few pieces out just to give you the idea. How it looks like later on. And I like it. So I will cut 6 tags quickly out. Oopsie. So, I am back in a second. So, ta-da, sorry. So now I have cut them into the sizes. Make the tag shape. I have here, this was a, I call it spam mail, junk mail. It was in a junk mail. I have used it now as a template. So, yeah, this was the mailman. That was now very weird. I don't know. I mean, it's okay, right? It's for healthcare purposes, but weird. Very weird. What has changed all overnight now? I don't know. So, I have to cut a little bit the corners because I have a blunt trimmer blade. It doesn't look so pretty if it's so. Give me a second, please. So I make 4 now to show you them. So, look. They look now so pretty. Tag shape. I think it's awesome. So I will now quickly distress here this, can you see it? Here this white edge, this is what I don't like. Just a little bit of distress ink here around. I don't want to bother you too much with this dressing tags. But this white edge I don't like. So, and now I will. So much better. It's a little bit flexible, that's great. Let me move this here out, this dirty mat out of the way. Now we see the next dirty mat. But now you can see it better with this other isn't it? I like them. I really like them. Love them. So I wanted to make some little tags because I have here, I have more all over the place, but I do two on camera and the rest then off camera to show you then the result. I have here print, sorry for my hands, printed out some Mrs. Cox images in smaller. They are original size, they are double size in original, but I wanted them here as a focal point for the tags. So I have here, I need a background. This would not work. So I have here a very old vintage book page. Where's my glue? Okay, so here's the glue. I just glued a little bit here in the middle because I want to sew around. And if you don't let your glue completely dry before you sew, you will ruin your sewing machine. Trust me. That happens to my last one, and I spent now a lot of money because I love my sewing machine and I want to keep it. So, oopsie, a little bit straight. So then you can now cut here around, you can tear it with the hand. I have this tear ruler and so this must stick there. I keep this. So I keep this. And so the second one. So I have them now. I distress here also a little bit the edge, but not too much. I don't want to darken too much of the writing of the book page. So just a little bit. And now I hope I don't make you seasick, because there's my Mr. Sewing Machine. And I will sew with a straight stitch around the picture. Let me move this out of the way. So please forgive me for the shaking of the camera. Just a straight stitch. I try to sew slowly. To not make you too sick. So it takes a little while. So one. So I cut a little bit the threads off, and all I'm doing now is to glue this here on top. That's for this little project. I think it's cute. So will finish the other text on off camera. I'm sorry that I always have to turn on and off the camera, but it takes me a while to make it, and I think I have already recorded a long time. Not sure how many minutes this is now. So they are really cute. And now I had here some scraps left. I glued them here. So these are just fabric scraps that I have in a jar. I have here this jar where I collect my scraps, fabric scraps, and the same as with the paper scraps. If it's full, I need to use it up. And for this little thing is here, it's always good to use the little scraps. So, oh. You can poke a hole and make it with this hole in the how you call it, with lace or what, or fabric or ribbon through this hole. That's also perfectly fine. You can use anything, and you can make them into this text any thing you want. So this has now to completely to dry because of the glue, because I plan now to sew here with a zigzag stitch around. It needs a little bit until this glue is, you know, dry, but as I said, I let it dry completely. I don't want to ruin my sewing machine, and when I have finished it, I will be back. I will be back with the end result. So hold on. I am back. So this is now the last part of this extremely long video, to show you the results of our mixed media background text, and now with a focal point on top. I call this Mrs. Cox Goes Mixed Media. So look at this cuties. I really like this text. So I have sewn here around with this leftover scrappy thingy, and this focal point here. You can add now more to your this tag, but I like it as it is. I must say, I don't want to add more because there's a lot of going on in the background, and I don't want to add more bulk to the journal when I put them in there. Some bees, botanicals. So it's a lighter one, it's okay. So Mrs. Cox Goes Mixed Media. I like them, how they turn out. I really like them. It was fun just to play a little bit, and I'm sorry that I had to speak my mind, but sometimes it's necessary. So you see, you can do a bunch of fun tags with this, just collage. If you want, put gesso on top, seal it, and play with colors. This was really all I did today, just play with colors, and look how they turn out with this stenciling here. You can see still the layering here, you can still see the stamp, and the brushwork colors are really fun here, the stamping and here the stenciling, so you can always see what you have created before with the text. So I close now this extremely long video. I'm sorry. This is the reason that I don't like to make these videos, because I need too much time to make these projects, and then I have to record parts of the videos, and then I put them together, and I don't know if that is so wanted. So if someone says, oh, I just turned the camera on and then crafting it in completely hour, that's great. I'm not able to do that. I make parts and then I have to stop. I have to dry things off camera. I cut anything. That's why I always try to avoid. And sometimes it's difficult to talk, to craft and to think. But I tried it this time. I hope you like this idea and give them a thumbs up. If you want to see more of those things in my shop, go check out. Link in the description box. Thanks for watching. Please stay healthy. Maybe avoid public if you can. Stay at home. Craft a lot. We will see you. We will see us together soon, I hope. Maybe I dare to make another video, I'm not sure. But I close this now here, and I wish you a wonderful day. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.